Hey, welcome to Smooth On. My name is Kevin and I'm here with my good buddy Ricky. We're here to show you our new project. It's a unique take on something you've probably seen before.
Yeah, that's right. If you see online, you see a lot of river tables or tables with epoxy in them. So what we wanted to do, we wanted to add life to it. So you know how much I love fish, so we made a lagoon table with a fish tank in it.
Yeah, it's quite the interesting project. So why don't we take you through the steps and show you how it's done.
To begin, we designed the table using a 3D modeling program. It will consist of a lot of custom pieces, a metal frame, press look columns, concrete and a clear epoxy tabletop, as well as an acrylic fish tank. Once we were satisfied with the overall design, it was time to build it. Melamine was the primary mold material due to the size and large flat areas of the table.
After building the mold, we applied sonette wax on the edges followed by a bead of silicone. The wax allows for the excess silicone to be removed easily. We then worked the silicone with a steel ball tool. This is going to give the concrete a beveled look. We also used sonette wax on the edges of the melamine to seal it.
Before we cast concrete, Aquacon release agent is applied. We like using a 4-part water to 1-part Aquacon ratio. Now it's time for the 4-ton GFRC mix. We follow the standard mixing procedures. For more information regarding GFRC components and the mixing process, check out our website. The 4-ton mix is fluid enough to spray easily while still holding a vertical surface. We try to start in a corner and work out from there. We don't want dry sand particles accumulating in the corners. This will cause problems for us later. To cast the island, we added PVA fibers and additional plasticizer and poured it on a vibrating table. Now back to the table. The second face coat is applied to ensure we have proper face coat thickness.
Now the fun part, we wait. We have to wait for the face coat to set up because if we apply the mix too early, you'll see the fibers in the face. We added these braces because our vertical walls were pretty high and we were applying the backer mix by hand. To make the backer, we use our vertical shaft mixer. We added 19 millimeter or 3/4 inch AR glass fiber to the mix as reinforcement. These are added gradually so as to not cause a bird's nest. Next, we apply the fiber backer coat to the piece. We want to ensure we have thorough coverage while being careful not to disturb the face coat. Bubble busters are then a great way to get the air out and orientate the fibers.
Since we'll be pouring epoxy on the back of this piece eventually, we want to ensure that it is as level and as even as possible. Now that the bottom is complete, we begin applying material to the vertical walls. This also allowed time for the mix to stiffen up a little so that it will hold a vertical surface better. Usually, we just add scrim to what would be the top of the piece, but since this is such a large piece and we are shipping it multiple times, we applied it to the walls as well. It's cheap insurance. As we mentioned, we will be pouring epoxy, so we would trowel the bottom to ensure it was flat as possible. The piece is covered with plastic and moving blankets for insulation. Good curing practices go a long way for concrete performance. Now it's Buddy's turn. He jumps in and builds the mold that will ultimately be our column and that will house all of the plumbing. Buddy Rhodes' Craftsman Mix gets a spin in the mixer. He's just the right guy to ensure that it's the right consistency. Buddy now uses his signature press technique for both the column and the cap. With that completed, it's time to cover the new concrete and uncover the cured table. Since this will be a display piece, we ground all the edges where someone might put their hand. Now it's time for the demold. The melamine mold and trim are removed and we see the piece for the first time. Once that is done, we demold the island, the column, and the cap. Buddy then uses bone paste to fill the voids. He uses two different colors to match the table. After the bone paste is cured, all the pieces are processed to a maximum of 200 grit.
To give the table the color we wanted, we used Buddy Rhodes glazes. First, we started with the green color and covered the entire table. Then we used blue. We applied this with a microfiber cloth and a random pattern. Last, we apply some olive to tone down the colors a bit and give the table a bit of an aged look. Since this is going to be a display or meeting table, we use reactive polyurethane sealer from Buddy Rhodes for the abrasion resistance. For instructions on this sealer, check out our Buddy Rhodes website. Now this is where things get really interesting.
Yeah, absolutely. So we want a clear surface, so we use a sheet of acrylic to pour our epoxy on. We needed a way to ensure that the epoxy would not leak under the table and ruin our finished top. So we decided to use Rebound 25 to create a temporary gasket that can be brushed on the finished surface. Since it is a silicone, we knew it wouldn't bond to the table. Rebound 25 is also used to keep our island in place as we pour. Once the Rebound 25 is cured, the axis is trimmed flush with the concrete. The material also compressed sufficiently, creating this very thin gasket. Since we are pouring a clear epoxy, we didn't want any dust or contaminants getting into the pour, so we hung plastic sheathing and created our own clean room. Before we poured, we did one final cleanup of the acrylic to ensure that there was no dust, fingerprints, or concrete on the surface. We chose EpoxAcast 690 because it is a clear and durable casting epoxy. The mix ratio is 100A to 30B. When mixing this material, it's important to mix it until the cloudiness goes away. Always pour into a clean bucket and mix it again. For more information, check out our website. When it's time to pour the material, pour it slow and steady, trying not to create turbulence. The maximum recommended thickness is 3/8 of an inch, so we are going to have to pour it in stages. We allowed the material to cure overnight before we pour another layer on top of it. It will be a total of 4 different pours. Okay, now it's time for our last layer. We dammed up the opening so we can pour a layer over the entire bottom of the piece. This will ensure we will have a good seal when we go to install our fish tank. A torch is used to break any bubbles that have formed while pouring. Once it is cured for 24 hours, we are ready to demold. The acrylic sheet is carefully separated from the cured EpoxAcast 690. Then, the Rebound 25 gasket is removed with no issues.
We designed the table to conceal the fish tank completely so that no plumbing or equipment was visible. This called for a custom-built shallow tank. We built the acrylic tank measuring 48 by 24 inches and only 6 inches deep. We used weld-on 4 to glue the tank together. Once the tank was ready, we made a gasket that will seal the tank to the epoxy on the table. We made this by attaching walls to the tank and pouring EcoFlex 0050. Once that cured, we removed the walls and the gasket was ready. We then drilled holes and installed the bulkheads for the plumbing and installed the acrylic walls in the middle of the table where the water line would be.
We begin the metal fabrication that will support the table. We tried to use the least amount of steel as possible so as not to take away from the look of the concrete or the fish tank. The table is assembled in the game room of SmoothOn. We began with the steel frame, followed by the fish tank.
We added some sand in the fish tank. This helped hide the plumbing for the overflow nicely. We added some plants, some rocks, and now we're finally ready for the concrete top. Once the tabletop is installed and secured, we're ready to add some water, and finally, some fish. Now the table is ready, we could enjoy it here for a little while before we ship it out to the next show.
So how do you think the project turned out, Ricky?
I think it's awesome. I love the fish. I love how these different elements came together. Looks amazing.
I agree. I hope you guys enjoyed it too. Please keep an eye out for our next projects.